a little flow out of the pummeling drill. When you're working in through here, we're going to capture the arm. I'm going to put a little triangle vise right here. I'm pushing my chest up against it, capturing the arm like this. I'm pulling in at the shoulder joint. My chest goes up against the forearm to keep it nice and locked. Because everybody hates this. When you bind somebody's arm like this, it's annoying as hell. They want to get that arm out, and so you can use that against them. In this particular case, we're using this as torque. So I'm going to go from here, I'm going to bring this up like this, and my rotation is going to tear the shoulder joint, which you get to watch live. I'm kidding. No. So in this particular case, I'm chest forward. I've got this nice and tight. So as I'm coming through here, all I have to do is do a nice short, quick jerk. He feels that immediately. So the shoulder joint won't take too much from that position. So again, that's out of the flow on this. When they're coming in, and you'll have people just trying to shoot in, trying to get up underneath you, capture it, bind it, move the leg out. Even if I'm in here like this, this sets up, if you're any good at knees, this sets up for knees like crazy. So it's a good one to play with. You catch it in flow, just like that, working it nice and tight, and they'll feel it. If the failures come where I am not pushing my chest up against this enough, I want to hug this as my favorite arm in the world. If you don't get that in play and have that mentality, you won't have the torque needed on that shoulder. If he does fall down and roll, I stay with him. I'm in top cover position. I've still got the arm in this position. I have an elbow in the face. I can start doing drops on him at this point, and it's in my favor.